Good morning, dear children. Welcome back to the class. So let's start the class, children. What we have done yesterday, do you remember? We did subtraction mentally. Do you remember how to do that? So what if the question is 9 minus 5? How will we subtract this mentally, children? We'll keep, which is the bigger number? 9 is the bigger number, isn't it? So bigger number will keep in mind, will keep in mind, okay, bigger number in mind, and smaller number, children, will open how many fingers? 5 fingers. 1 2 3 4 5, okay, 5 fingers we will open. Now, children, we will do backward counting. Before 9, what comes? 8 7 6 5 4. So where it stops, children? 4. So 9 minus 5 is what? 4. Keep 9 in your mind. Open 5 fingers. Now start doing backward counting before 9. That is 8 7 6 5 4. So the difference is 4. The answer is 4. Isn't it? It's easy. So let's start the class. So children, let's start the class. The objective of the class is to understand the word problems. Today we will do some of the examples of word problems from your textbook. So let's start. Open your textbook, children. Page number 53. Let's start with example 3. These examples are, children, will give you the concept of subtraction and to solve some real life situations. So these questions are based on some real life situations. Okay, so let's start with example 3. A class of 390 students is divided in red and blue group. Children, how many students are there in a class? 390 students. Okay. And it is divided between two groups. One group is red group. One is red. And the next is blue group. Okay. It is divided into two groups. Clear? Among them, 150 students are in red group. So, total 390 are there. Out of 390 students, children, how many students are there in red group? 150 students are in red group. Okay. How many students are in the blue group, children? Now, total how many students are there? There is a group of 390 students. Okay. So, out of 390, you can remove 150. So, how many students are left, children? So, the remaining children will be in the blue group. The number of remaining children will be in the blue group. So when some students are removed from the group and the remaining, it is said the remaining students are in blue group. So what we are going to do, the word removed, then how many students are in the blue group, then children, it is asked that the remaining students will be in the blue group. So when it is asked how many will be in the blue group, then children, it is asking that how many are left, how many students are left, and the left students will be in the blue group. So what you are going to do, when the word left is there, so we are going to do subtraction. The first line is what, children? A class of 390 students. Total how many students are there? 390. So we'll write number of students in the class. How many students? 390. Next, among them, 150 students are in red group. What statement will you write? Number of students in red group. You will put the number after is equal to. So how many students are in red group? 150. Now they are asking how many students are there in the blue group. Number of students in blue group. So what we are going to do? We are going to do subtraction. We are going to subtract 150 from 390. That is from total students. So 390 minus 150. You will arrange and do the subtraction. We always start the subtraction from ones place, isn't it? 0 minus 0 is 0. 9 minus 5 is 4. So children, yesterday itself we have done your mental subtraction, how to do subtraction mentally. So keep the bigger number in mind, keep 5 in mind, open 5 fingers, then you start backward counting children from 9. That is your, before 9 what comes? 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Just see, you are getting 4 here. Okay, then 3 minus 1. If you keep 3 in your mind children, open one finger, then backward counting 2. You have to just one step before you have to see, that is 2. Then how many students are in blue group children? 240 students in blue group. Is it clear? Next, example 4. There are 52 candies in a jar. There is a jar. And how many candies are there in a jar, children? 52 candies. Okay? Children ate up 37 of them. Now, out of the group of 52 children, out of you have 52 chocolates. Candies means you have candies, okay? So, out of 52 candies, you ate 37 of them. Now, how many candies remain with you? Or it is asked, how many candies are left in the jar? When the word left is asked, children, what we do? Subtraction. Okay? So, how to write the statement? First line is what, children? There are 52 candies in a jar. So, you will write number of candies in a jar is equal to how many? 52. After full stop, next statement is, children ate up 37 of them. Next, what will come? Number of candies eaten by children. How many candies? 37. Okay. The third statement is, children, so there are, what they asked, how many candies are left in the jar? Number of candies left in the jar. Okay. So left means what we are going to do? Subtraction. 52 minus 37. You arrange. Then, can you subtract 7 from 2? No. What we are going to do? We are going to borrow 1 from 5. So, 2 becomes 12 and 5 becomes 4. So, 12 minus 7 is, children, 5. And 4 minus 3 is 1. So, what do you get here? 15. So, how many candies are left in the jar? 15 candies are left in the jar. Is it clear? You can do this in your copy, children. Next example, 5, page number 54. Let us now learn to frame a story sum based on subtraction. We have learned how to frame a story sum based on addition in our previous chapter, isn't it? Here we'll learn how to frame a story sum based on subtraction. So you see, children, the exam question is, given 163 minus 120 is equal to 43. Frame a story sum. Now let's frame a story sum, children. Two numbers and their difference are given, isn't it? Two numbers and their difference. Difference means answer is given. We can use a situation to frame the story sum. You can frame your own story also, children. So the first step is, think of a situation. Think of any situation. Okay, whether you can be in the class or you can think about the school, you can think about at home or birthday. Okay, anything, any situation you think. So let's see what is written here. Shyam takes some chocolates to school. So he has taken the situation of school, birthday. Shyam takes some chocolates to school on his birthday. Since it is subtraction, these chocolates should be given away. So children, Shyam took chocolates to school on his birthday to give away to children. Okay? So when he gave, so as it is a subtraction frame story, children, so we have to think about giving the chocolates. Second, write the story in your words. Now let's see what story Shyam has framed. Shyam takes 163 chocolates to school on his birthday. Full stop. He shares 120 chocolates among his classmates. He took how many chocolates in the school? Total 163. And 120 chocolates he distributed among the classmates. Question, how many chocolates are left with him? Isn't it easy, children? This is the final one. This is the answer, children. This is the answer. Okay? Am I clear to everyone? When you will write the answer, children, you need not write these steps. You need not write this step, children. You need not write this. This is not required. This is not required. This is the answer. Okay? So you can frame your own story also. These are the steps that how to frame, that you have to think of the situation. And you can think of any situation. As it is discussed about the birthday situation, children, you can think of some other situation also. Let's move to next. David had rupees 9 with him. He gave rupees 4 to his sister. How much amount was left with David? Can you think over it, children? David had rupees 9 with him. He gave rupees 4 to his sister. How much amount was left? When the word left is used, children, what we are going to do is subtraction. Rupees 9 minus rupees 4. Okay? So, rupees 9 minus rupees 4, children. You can do subtraction mentally. Keep the bigger number in mind. Open 4 fingers. Then start backward counting. 8, 7, 6, 5. So, 9 minus 4 is what? Rupees 5. Clear? So, how much amount was left with David? Rupees 5. Can you find out without using pen and paper, children? It is very easy. Do it mentally, isn't it? We can do it mentally. Next, you can do this, children. To subtract numbers mentally, we need to remember the correct orders of the numbers. It is very important to remember the correct orders of numbers. Also, we need to practice backward counting of numbers. As I told you, children, if you are subtracting 9 minus 5, then 9 will be, bigger number will be in your mind. That is, 9 will be in your mind. You will open 5 fingers. And you will start backward counting. You know backward counting, children? So, backward counting, you will start the backward counting from 9. That is 9. What comes before 9? 8. Then what comes before 8? 7. Before 7? 6. Before 6? 5. Then before 5? 4. So, how many steps we have to count, children? 5. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Understood? So, what is the difference? 9 minus 5 is 4. Am I clear? You have to understand, practice the backward counting of numbers. Take out page number 54. You can do this, children, in your book. Let us recall how to write numbers backward from 20 to 1. 20 to 1, children. 20 is here. Then back before 20, what comes? 19. 18. This is how you will write till 1. Clear? Next example. These are so this solve the following mentally you can do in your book itself. So 8 minus 6, 8 will keep in your mind and you will open 6 fingers. So start counting backward children. 6 fingers means you are going to use both the hands. 7, count after me. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. So 7, 8 minus 6 is what? 2. Clear? This is how you can do B and C. Am I clear to everyone, children? So this we will discuss in our next class. That's all for today, children. You can practice this, what we have discussed today, in your copy. The examples, you can do it in your copy. That's all for today. Thank you so much.